Welcome to the 2022 World Feeder Championships. Held in Belgium at the impressive Maasplassen in Gestingen, a live gravel pit that is connected to the huge river Maas that snakes its way throughout Europe. A perfect venue for world championships, boasting all kinds of species such as bream, roach, asp, perch, grundles, all manner of fish to target. An impressive venue for such an event. For those who have never been to a world championship or are not familiar with how it is run, the match is broken down into a practice week that is 5 days long and then a 2 day match at the end of the practice week. The practice week is vital for the teams to collate information, learn the tactics, learn the species that they're targeting, and each team takes it very seriously. We join England on day four of practice after 3 tricky days practice. Things are looking up for England in day four, a much better box, a much better area, and we join England manager Dean Barlow to find out how the week's gone.
So, Dean.
Hello, Joe.
We're in day four of the practice week. Can you just tell us a little bit about what goes into a practice week, what you're trying to achieve, what you're doing yourself like in this situation? What's the crack?
Obviously, we get told what areas of the competition we're going to be in. They're called box numbers. So every day you practice that box, 6 of you in a certain box. So we go in, practice it. And like today, we're in box 7, and part of my job as such, as you can see, I'm counting fish, trying to get as much information as possible, which I can transfer down to the anglers. The idea of counting fish is you can get an average of what the size are and what the stamp is. So come the weekend, because every fish is counted in the World Championship, so if I know we've got, say, 32 roach and they're 2 ounce a piece, and someone's got 30 roach, I've got a good idea where they might be in their section. So that's that exercise. And I'm just like watching now all the time, and I feel if I see one of the lads doing something, or if they like make me aware of something, I can just transfer that information down the line to the lads. Like, we've been fishing 2 hours today, and we had 37 roach and 27 other little fish. And then the second hour, we've had 48 roach and 27 other little fish again. But looking at it now, it's slowed down so much. You look across the match venue, and it seems to be areas that was catching earlier that's not catching now. And vice versa, there's some people who wasn't catching are catching now. So at times like this, I've got to make a call whether somebody tries something different. You can't just sit there catching nothing, because if you keep doing the same thing, the same thing happens. So
the guys, obviously you've got 6 anglers, only 5 can fish.
Yes.
How is that selection process done then? Is it best results for the week? Is it a good feeling? Is it a bit of everything?
It's a bit of everything, because the main thing is these guys are a 6. And as a 6, we work the best method out, and that's how it is. It's not a 5-and-1 situation. Unfortunately, somebody, could be anybody, is not going to fish on Saturday. But we come as a 6, we fish as a 6, we get the method as a 6, and that's how it is.
So, obviously this venue, looks like it's predominantly roach and bream. Are they the main target?
Hopefully. Yeah, it's mostly it's mostly roach with some asp, which is like a little predatory fish. It's more like a chub, but they're only small, like 2 ounces, a big one. There's some tiny perch, some good perch as well, which are showing in odd areas. And then there's some bream between. As we look at Adam Wakelin's, looks like he's got a nice roach on, but the roach go up to like 2 pound. Yeah, they're absolutely stunning fish, just beautiful gravel pit roach.
So with a day left to go tomorrow,
yeah,
how are you feeling?
Well, I'm glad we've actually drawn in an area where we can actually catch some fish, because anyone who's been following the progress on social media knows that we haven't had the best of draws. But it's one of those, you need to, it's not all about just catching loads of fish all the time. It will give you a false setting of what the actual venue is. There's some really, really good fishing and some really poor fishing. It's like today, We've got a few guys, Eddie Bryden's on the other side of the lake watching the Hungarians. They've caught 24 bream today. So it's, you know, we're still, we've got one of the guys, Graham West, he's with the Irish guys. I'm gonna turn him off, he'll be after. He's looking at the Irish guys, they're in a harder box today. So we're just passing information back and forward all the time.
So you've got several guys dotted around?
Yeah, the backup team, obviously, there's obviously myself, there's Graham West, Eddie Bryden, Jamie Harrison, and Rich Wilson, who helped do all the bait and get everything prepared. So all these guys here, the lucky six, as I call them, all they need to do is concentrate on their fishing, and that's what they need to do. So, but we've also got Tom Mertens, who comes and watches us every year. Tom's from Holland. He started coming with us, what, about 2014 in Tunisian, didn't you?
Yeah,
and then we've got Aid Cadell, who lives over here. He's come, he's our catering manager. So we've got a good team. We've got a really good team, and it's vitally important that I like the fishermen just to think about fishing. That's what they're here for.
It's been a bizarre day for me. Load of roach at the start, and then caught a bream, and then virtually biteless for 2 hours or more, from a bite of chuck to nothing. And then another little spell where some roach moved in, hooked five in as many casts, and then nothing. And then I've had a skimmer at the end. So really strange day. Tried a few other things in amongst that, but.
It's weird, Will, because in the middle of the match, every day, wherever we are, bites just go, don't they?
Yeah,
there's a few bites, and then
we've seen it before when we've watched a match on here, and everybody seems to catch again at the end.
Yeah,
it's like a bizarre place. I mean, I've changed to a line a lot further out, didn't I? And not even a bite on bloodworm or anything like that. But you're just wasting time for when them fish come back.
Yeah,
I think I could have caught a few more roach
right.
If I'd have come back earlier.
The same, I had 4 to 5 minutes out for nothing. And when I went back, even though it was slow, I could catch an odd roach.
Yeah.
And I certainly could have caught.
How many roach did you have? You had quite a few in the end, didn't you?
50, I've just counted back. 50 bloody roach and a dozen perch I've had. So.
Yeah. That's a big difference. I've only had 16 roach.
Have you?
Yeah.
Oh, right.
Yeah. So
50 roach, and but what was interesting for me was, as well, in the early part of the match I could catch on like casters,
yeah,
and then at the latter part of the match worms were best,
yeah,
almost
yeah.
As if like the fish had like come on the feed stronger.
Well, we've got all of this colour coming to it. It's almost like, is it because that's what they can find? But the trouble is, you've got no colour at the weekend because the barges aren't going to work.
I don't know if they just warm up a bit in the day.
It might just be
a funny time of year where they warm up a bit in the day, and then later on in the day they're looking for meatier baits.
Yeah, might just be roach o'clock.
And, you know. And we've also seen Mick catch some skimmers late, which has happened every time we've been here. If there's some skimmers to be caught, you know, an hour to go, and then three skimmers, it makes a big difference. So, you know, we're you know, it's an interesting scenario.
Yeah, it's a very, very frustrating venue, isn't it? You know, in terms of you can't seem to force anything to happen in that slack spell, can you?
No, absolutely not. You certainly can't. Well, we've got one more day at it, but we're not going to a bit where we're going to catch 4 kilo of roach tomorrow. So
I think this is our one and only day's practice this week.
Yeah, yeah.
We've been a little bit unfortunate with the boxes what we've drawn.
How do you think 4.5 kilo will be on the day along here? I mean, it's hard to say, isn't it? But I'm saying you're going to be what, top 5 or 6 in your section with that sort of
Yeah,
work,
I would
think?
Have said so. Yeah, it's definitely going to be worse than the last match that we watched on here, isn't it? So
Well, let's get some gear packed away, and we shall go and have a go again tomorrow. Hey,
good idea.
Sounds good.
Day 4 has without doubt been our best day yet. Our weights are good. In fact, I'd say we've caught more fish than I expected us to catch. Personally, it's been a little bit I'd like to have caught more, but I think everyone would like to have caught more, but I've learned a lot. And when you're practicing for world champs, it's about learning. And I feel like if I had another 5 hours at this peg, there's another kilo and a half to be caught, which is, that's going to be vital come Saturday, Sunday. So it's been a really good day, the best day we've had. Yeah, we've got one more day to go, which I don't think we're going to a great box, but it'd be interesting to see if what we've learned here then holds up there. So, no, it's the best day we've had so far. I think all the lads will be buzzing, a bit more confidence. I think ground bait wise, we've finalised the mix today. It's been pretty conclusive when you look at the weights. So we're moving in the right direction.
Dean, good day's practice.
Yeah, thank God we've had a chance to go in a box with a few fish. So yeah, we're a lot happier today. Like I've said before, we haven't really had a chance to catch any fish yet. So when you do get the opportunity, when you catch a few fish, you know how you're doing compared to the teams who's been in the boxes around here.
So you've had a bit of a proper look today, haven't you, rather than...
Yeah, it's always difficult because during the week you always get reports back from other teams. They've had this many kilo, that many kilo, and not being on anywhere where there's been any amount of fish, it's difficult to like compare what we've had. So we've had a chance to come in these boxes today, and yeah, I'm quite happy that I think we've caught our fair share.
So obviously confidence is back up now, isn't it? Everyone's had a good day, caught some
fish,
had some bites.
Confidence has always been good, Joe, because you can only you can only catch what you think's in front of you, and so we're quite happy that after today, that if we draw on some fish, we're going to catch them. And if we draw in the hard areas, the practice we've had in the hard areas has been quite good. So we are confident, you know.
International rules style fishing is everything has to be measured out. You're going to get a bait check, so you can't have over. You can have under, but you cannot have over your limits. You've got certain amounts. I'm not going to say what we're using at minute, but we are taking the maximum amount to us peg what we're allowed of allocation page day, whether it be pinkies, casters, maggots, red worms, dendrobinas, joker, bloodworm. All this has to be measured out every day on a daily basis, so it's super fresh. Perfect. We've got, so this is a 3/4 litre tub, a quarter litre tub, half a litre tub. Everything's going to be measured to absolute perfection. So this is all part of fishing that some people don't see. This is a vital part. At minute, lads are setting up, they can just concentrate on their tackle, on the rigs, plumbing depth, don't have to worry about that. We'll deliver bait to their peg at end so they can just turn around, put it on the bait tray. They don't have to worry about it being wrong, right. We've already had a chat with them. We know exactly what they want, when they want it, how they want it, and also why they want it. And it helps at end of day. We can, if somebody's caught a few more than others, is it because they took a bit more of this to the peg? Is it because they fed a bit more of this? And at end of day, we collect all the bait up and we do monitor it. We have a look. Why have you only got this amount of caster say? Why have you got this amount of worms left? Why have you got this amount of joker left? And it's sort of part of, you just form a picture of what, how they've caught. Sometimes they might not remember why they've got a bit less bait left because they fed for an hour, didn't feed for an hour. Just helps us know what they want for next day. So when we come to do their bait, we know what they want and why they, but most importantly, why they want it.
Morning. So it's Friday, which is day five of practice and the last day of practice. Massive day because the weekend's looming. And it's a big day in many, many ways, not just because tomorrow we start the competition, but it's time to bring together all the work that we put in for the last, I'm not going to say 5 days, because this has been going on for months, and we've been here for 8 days. And but in the last 5 days, we've fished a selection of boxes. Today we're in box 19. It's very different to everywhere else we've been. It's in a bit of a channel. We're on a big point on what is known as the island. And today we get a chance to put through a lot of what we've learnt and then challenge it against itself and just make sure that we're going into tomorrow, into battle, with the correct tactics and the correct plan. So everybody's keyed up, everybody's feeling it now, because as the tension builds and the momentum of all this comes together, and we're going to go marching off in the morning to compete and keep ourselves in it. You can never win it on day one, but you can certainly keep yourselves in the race. So massive, massive day, really looking forward to it. And you know, the sun's coming up and we're all getting ready and we've plumbed up and we're ready to go.
Yes, mate, yeah.
What do you think? Has it been a good day?
Better than we expected. There's been absolutely nothing caught in this box all week. And the only thing that I knew is that the two end pegs would, if there's anything was going to be caught, that's where they would catch them, because it's going towards the fish. And if you notice, this is like a boating channel here. So, and Adam and Stephen, Adam started catching first, then Stephen, and for about an hour and a half, and then Rob caught a fish, and it's sort of like gone on. In the last hour, Liam's had a bite, and then all of a sudden he's got like 15, 16 roach and just had a perch near a pound, and it's sort of like they've just moved round to Mick. He's just had two in two chucks. So yeah, it's a I'm quite happy that when the fish are available, we've caught them. So yeah,
it's really obvious there. I walked around a lot of the length, and there's some real tough bits. But the lads, like you say, as soon as they're on some fish, catching better than anyone. So
yeah, which means that, I mean, like I say, we've only had probably one day on any fish. That was yesterday. Mick's just caught another one now, and he's had nothing for 4 hours, and he's just had 3 and 3 chooks. So when the fish move in, we're quite confident that we've sorted a method out to catch them.
The end of the last day of practice, Dean.
Yeah.
A big moment for you guys. Do you want to just quickly run us through what's happened today? Because it's been a really good day for the lads.
God, yeah, we've been like, we expected it to be really difficult in this box today, but we've had a nice surprise. There was a few fish here, and the guys have caught really well. We've all had more or less 5 kilos apiece, which is a good weight, which is like in old money. 12, 13 pounds.
Yeah, and it's all roach as well.
All roach from a box that hasn't seen over a kilo all week. So, and the most important thing, Joe, is I've always said we had one go in the main lake, because we're in like an arm here, we're in like a channel, and we had a go on the main lake yesterday on box 7, and we learned quite a bit yesterday how to catch these roach. And we've put that into practice today. There's been a few roach available, and we've caught as well as anybody on the bank. So, we're leaving on a high.
Yeah, so the big moment, one of many big moments.
The big announcement.
The big announcement. Do you want to tell us what the team is going to be for the weekend?
The team I've selected to fish on Saturday is Mick Viles, Adam Wakelin, Rob Wotton, Lee Kerry and Steve Ringer. On this occasion, Will Freeman's going to sit the Saturday out. Will's been absolutely brilliant all week, and it's just not really gone his way. So I have to make a decision, a horrible decision, but we are a six and we all work hard together, and there's always going to be someone who's going to be left out, unfortunately.
Yeah, and obviously Will now has a really important job of working on the bank as well,
isn't he?
Which is vital, isn't it, in these championships?
Well, you've got a world-class angler who's running the bank for you. It doesn't get any better than that, does it? No.
So what's the deal now? Obviously, have you got like some meetings and stuff to go to? Or?
5 o'clock, I've got a captain's meeting where I go and they draw. I'll hand the team sheet in and we draw for sections. So the guys, I'm losing my voice, the guys will know what section they're going to, which is really handy on this venue, Joe, because the viewers that have been watching know that there's A and B section on one side of the lake, and then there's like a big peninsula that has C, D and E section. So at least they know what they're going to expect in what section.
So big day, obviously massive day. And then the actual draw for the pegs is done in the morning, is it?
Tomorrow morning, nice and early, draw for pegs. Let's just hope that the drawback's kind to us.
So it's 10 to 8 and we're stood behind the tapes. We're allowed to put the tackle just into that no man's land, which is the 1 metre strip. And we have to wait for the 8 o'clock hooter, Will, don't we?
Yeah, 8 o'clock hooter, the anglers can put the stuff in the box and start to set up then, but not before. Yeah. And then you've got like a dividing tape. So spectators behind the tape, captains and whatever, can go in the tape line, and then only captains, vice captains and reserves can go down to the angler.
Yeah.
So even runners can't go any more than that side of the tape. So it's not so bad here because you're quite close to the anglers, but on the other sections where you've got a big slope, you're a little bit further away. So
the other thing that has to be kept within that is the bait. So the bait has to stay up tape side until the bait check, which is that will start at 10 to 9. Usually, I think if you have a really big section, today is 23, and it was split, they'd have two starts, but because it's a one section, I'll probably be quite early. They'll start at B1 and check bait, and then that means then you can prepare worms, because you're not allowed to chop a worm before the bait check. Your ground bait has to be mixed. You can't add water apart from with a sprayer after that. So you have to prepare everything. It's all presented in official measures. And that's litres, there's 2.5 litre bait limit, of which you can have 3/4 litre of Joker, 1/2 litre of worms, and then your ground bait at 12 litres. That includes hemp and any corn.
Any, so, any inert bait, so corn,
yeah, that's right.
Lean, that sort of stuff.
So we're just waiting for that ooter to start in 7 minutes. And
happy with the draw?
Yeah. I mean, personally, we practiced just here. I think 35, about 3 or 4 pegs down. I snared a few bream, which were a good day. But if they're not feeding, there's some roach to be caught as well. Rob's quite close. He's at the top end of A. I think we'd have preferred a low A section, but Rob will do it. Not a problem at all whatsoever.
Yeah, I think it's just a little bit past Rob is probably the worst bit of his section. So hopefully he's.
He's an even section. It's tough for everybody, isn't it? D, which is where Steve is, that's going to be a tough gig, but he's the man for that job. And Lee is in what we call the right mix-up section, which is C. It's going to be a real bag of tricks, that.
Yeah, C section points to 3 different areas of the lake. It's round a point, so these anglers cast them that way, these anglers cast them that way, and those anglers cast them that way. So Lee's right on the point, sort of almost cast them back into the main body of the lake.
It is
just over there, so hopefully he'll catch a few fish there. It's not too bad,
but it's only day one. There's 2 days in this competition, so let's get some points on the board and then start again tomorrow, see how we get on.
What do you reckon, Rob?
Well, do I reckon? Well, the hoot has just gone to me to get my gear in, so I'm not going to hang around, but I'm M-pegging A section. It's not an M-peg because obviously just the sections run onto each other. I might be not in the best area in the section, because I think the point area down at the bottom end, maybe sort of A 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, I think that could be a good area, but I'm surrounded by good anglers and usually they draw good pegs, so I'm hoping I'm in a good area. I've got Torsten to my left, I've got Arnott from Holland to his left, and I've also got in the next section along Romantis from Ireland, obviously all fantastic anglers. I think that means there's some fishing in this area.
Good lord.
It's a beautiful day, you know, Joe. Like,
looks lovely, doesn't it?
For fishing, it's overcast. A beautiful day. Overcast.
Nice time, isn't it?
It's a beautiful day, so, yeah, who knows? I'm going to get my platform in, and then...
Shoulders back.
Shoulders back, and we'll smash it, hopefully.
Middle of E section, Joe, pretty much, he 10. Obviously, we were here day one. We were right on the end box, which surprisingly, some of it got taken out. The last 3 pairs got taken out because obviously they don't need them. So, don't know. just trying to wind the fishing. I think looking at it, 3 kilos will be mega. Get to 3 kilos. Obviously, the bank runner, Eddie, does a good job, keeps me informed. If we need to push for a bigger fish, that's what we'll have to do. If not, just want to look, try and get some bites, Joe. Settle in, and I don't, you know, this all week it's not been great, but it seems to be the fairest section, I think, Eddie, hasn't it?
Yeah, you know how you stand now, after what I seen yesterday.
You ran this section yesterday?
Yeah, we're on here all day yesterday. Me and Graham, I'd done the top half, he'd done the bottom half, and from what we've seen, the best I heard were 2.8 kilo, which were a lot of small fish. One or two bonus perch, like 6, 8, 10 ounce. One or two dumpy roach up to 4 ounce. And basically, you've just got to keep in touch with your bites all day. The top end of the section weren't very good. I've just been informed that, whether it's, you know, just rumours or what, there was a couple of big 3s and a 5 kilo off the high numbers of the section yesterday. But when I were down there, I didn't see anybody catching anything, to be fair. Different day today. Well, as you can see on the board here, I've put a little line top to bottom where I think we need it to draw. He's drawn bang on. So, and he's the right lad for the job because he likes catching peckers. So he's in Peckersville today.
So, let's hope so.
Let's hope so.
So we're just getting ready for the start of day one of the World Feeder Championships, and behind Lee Kerry, who's drawn C18, which is in a good area. It's not quite as prolific as the pegs to the right, but it's still very, very good. And in fact, when the lads came in earlier in the year to have a look, this was a really good area. Now, in the World Championships, you actually get a 10-minute pre-baiting session. So the match starts at 10 a.m. and the match itself, the pre-baiting itself, should I say, gets up and running at 10 to. So it gives them a nice 10-minute window where they can accurately pre-bait the swims, get everything sorted. There they go, there's the hooter. So now Lee will feed probably two lines, but not 100% sure, probably two lines. With a nice big feed, like a feeding feeder. It looks like he's chucking about 40 metres. And it gives them 10 minutes without any pressure to get started or anything like that. They've just got 10 minutes to get all the bait in, get their little areas established before another hooter will go at 10 a.m, which allows them to put hook on and get going. So Lee will take his time, get nice and get everything nice and in position, just punching that feeder out. Okay, so we are behind Steve Ringer, who has the envious task of taking on peg D20. Now, this is a very difficult draw, potentially, that, you know, has a potential for a real spanner in the works. Now, we're 50 minutes into the match, and Steve has got 6 roach, which is a really good start. It may not sound like a lot, but we fully expected Steve maybe to catch some roach later, if at all. Maybe having to fish for little asp and perch and things. So the fact that Steven's caught, you know, a number of roach so early is really encouraging. And since I've been here, he's already missed a couple of bites. Getting indications, had a fish while I've been here, so there's obviously some roach here. This is where Will drew in the practice yesterday and had a really tough day, never caught a roach, so obviously everyone was worried. But if there's one man that can, it's Mr. Ringer. There we go. Another fish. Fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. Another roach by the looks of it. He's not messing about today. A little perch. So a really important part of this event is obviously the role that the captains and management play to convey tactics. Another roach there for Steve. So decisions can be made whether to stick or twist in these kind of events. You know, it may be that at one point they maybe say, right, now you can have a gamble for maybe a big perch or a skimmer or something. It doesn't look like there's ever any skimmers in this area, to be perfectly honest, but you know, or whether to maybe drop short and try and catch some of the asp that are in this lake. Small perch, those little grumbles, or perhaps even stick at what you're doing. And obviously, as you see, Jamie Harrison there has just been now conveyed a little message, and Steve can now continue fully informed on what's happening. So, you know, bank runners can play a really important role, especially when you're in the situation that Steve is, where it's not clean cut as to what you're up against.
Okay, so we are behind Adam Wakelin, who is on peg E10. Now, this is a tough area, but one where there are bites. You know, unlikely to catch any skimmers or bream, but that goes for the whole section. They're all unlikely to catch any skimmers or bream, so potentially this could be a nice even section and one where it's all about getting your head down. Now, he's got 30 fish, which are not little peckers, they're decent fish. Little roach, chunky perch, that kind of thing. Michael Buchwalder is three anglers to his left and he's trying to catch loads of little fish on a feeder. So, he's catching as many as 50 fish an hour, tiny fish. So we think that they're 7 grams each, the fish that Michael are catching. Whereas Adam's fish are a little bit better than that. So although the fish count, that's a tiny fish. Although the fish count is very high for Michael, and he is motoring, has to be said. We're hoping that Adam's approach, a little bit further out in the lake, fishing a bit more positive, is going to pay off over 5 hours. So that's the plan, that's the hope. See, Captain Dean's there. Michael is like a windmill, in and out with small fish, small perch, small grundles, little asp. But he's trying to just get his head down and catch loads of fish, whereas obviously Adam is a little bit more patient, a bit more further out and doing his thing. So an interesting contrast here, really, between the two anglers. It'll be interesting at the weigh-in what they've got. Moving on to B section, and we're sat with Mick Viles now, and you see his runner, sixth man in the team, Will Freeman, passing on some instruction. Now this section is a real mixed bag, it has to be said. Mick's doing okay, but the guy to his left is catching lots of small fish. Roach, catching really well. Mick on the other hand's having a bit of a tough time with it. There seems to be a lack of bites for Mick at the moment, and when he does get a bite, it's the wrong sort of fish. Small perch and stuff, so this is a little interesting move, this, because I don't think anyone's catching any bream in this section. But Mick's not catching loads of roach neither, and there are several people in this section catching roach, so this is further up on B section where Mick is. And the man there is playing something very big. Whether it's a bream or a... Let's have a look. Bream with a wig on, perhaps. There's a good fish in there, whatever it is. Just a decent roach caught in some weed after all that. But that's good, at least it's not a bream. And this is where championships are won and lost sometimes, that the decisions that are made, whether they get Adam to stick with this or whether they get him to go small fish fishing. It looks like maybe the team are about to make a change as we speak. And this is where, you know, a manager can really make a difference, has to make these big calls that could pay off or could go the other way. So obviously what Michael's doing, is having an impact on what Adam is going to do in this section. See, Adam is fantastic at this small fish. See, he's making it looks like he's making a change. So there you go, small rod. I think he's going to go small fish fishing for a bit, see if he can get that going. So this will be really interesting, see how this goes. So down in B section, we have the check angler next to Mick. He's had a great day catching roach and, well, just loads of fish to be fair, 50 fish an hour. It looks like he's hooked his first bream. Now, he looks to be having a great day. It could be a big roach, of course, or a perch, something, but there have been bream late on in this section, so wouldn't be a stretch. It could be a perch. Big bream, good fish, very good fish.
With just 20 minutes to go of day one, Mick Viles certainly needed a bit of a bonus to get him firing up that leaderboard, and he got it in the shape of this huge roach. At well over a pound, it's a massive and very welcome bonus that would certainly get him some extra points. Sections are always incredibly tight in the World Championships, with grams separating the weights. So Mick was absolutely over the moon to net this roach. Little did we know what would come the very next cast. As you can see, Mick latches into what is clearly a proper fish, immediately rises to his feet. Now, interestingly, this venue had loads of steep shelves, gravel beds, and all sorts of business to navigate your fish around. You could often see the anglers getting as high as possible to try and get them fish away from any possible problems and snags. Mick is one of the most experienced anglers in the England feeder team, and certainly knows how to keep it cool when the chips are down and the pressure's on. As you can see, Mick standing up, making sure to keep that fish away from any unwanted snags or any problems that may lurk on the bottom. But incredibly calm, and his bank runner Will Freeman, looks like he's just sat having a day's fishing with his mate. Incredibly calm given the situation and the pressure. Because this fish, who knows, could be the difference between a medal or not come the end of the weekend. A prime 2 pound skimmer, and that's well over probably a kilo and a half in two casts. When weights are only likely to be 5 kilos and under, that is a massive bonus on a day like today.
Mick, day one's over. What have you had?
5 kilo, 860, I think it was, 840.
which was greatly helped. I've had a big roach and a skimmer at the end. I could tell my peg, I had 8 or 9 roach on bounce, and after a really hard lull, and I thought, oh, here we go, and I'll catch this till the end. And it just went dead again. And as we've learnt on here, that sometimes means that there's a bream or a skimmer. The trouble is they don't always feed. The mid-water fish, they're not sort of, it's a hard bottom, and they hang there and put everything else off. Anyway, look, as at it, I've had a roach pound and a skimmer that were probably 2 pound. So that's pushed me up. To be fair, the lad to my left is fish for small fish, asp. So he's underhanded it and caught, I think he had 150 fish at halfway stage. And then he's put a big line in and caught a bream. And he's actually done me with about 80 grams, which is a bit of a pain. But he's fished well, and that's that. But that wasn't our plan. We had to catch these roach, which I think I've had I think I've had 49 roach, probably 20 or 30 small fish perch and things like that. The scales are halfway up the section. Will Freeman, number one bank man, he's a great guy. He knows everything that's going off, and he thinks I should be top five, which I didn't realise this during the match, because it's quite an intense match. It's roach fishing. You can't take your eyes off your tip, because they're quick bites, and you've kind of, you know, you've got to really, really focus. And he tells me that this has been the hard end of the section. So I think he said it's, you know, it's a good result from here. So I'm pleased with that, which is great. Rob, I know, has been catching roach. I think he's putting a sterling performance. He's only 5 pegs down. And I'm not sure what's happening with the other lads, but I've not heard any negative, so we look forward to it. See how we've got on halfway stage.
Day one results are in, D. Happy?
Yeah, an early out. Yes, from the draw. Because when I realised where we drew in two sections, I feared the worst, because you wouldn't pick those areas. Stephen was an absolute shocker. But he's pulled it out of the bag, to be fair. He's come 14th out of 23. I would have took 14 at the start of the match and told him not to fish. And then Rob has been completely the wrong end of his section. He's had nearly 5 kilo roach, but they've caught bream and everything up the top end of his section in like peg, from peg 4 to like 9. So you couldn't be any further away from the fish. But good result from Mick, fourth. Brilliant result for Adam, fourth, who's that section. He's had 2.2 kilo, only 2.5 has won it, so he's done brilliant from there. And Lee Kerry, eighth in section, which he was flying at one stage and couldn't get a bite. His tips flew around and he's played a fish to death. What we thought was a big bream and turned out to be 6 pounds under, which don't count. So not very lucky day, but we're still in the hunt. We're sixth with 40 points, with only 29 winning it, and with 23 peg sections, you can pick that up in one section. So just about to go and do the draw now, so all to play for. So yeah, a little tiny bit disappointed, but I don't think we could have done any more from the draws that we've had.
Day two, how are we feeling?
We're feeling good, aren't we?
I think we are feeling good, yeah.
Yeah, we're feeling good. It's a strange one, this venue, because it's not, as we thought before, it's going to be a high score. The nature of the venue leads itself to a higher score. So we are 11 points behind the team in first, and you can have that swing in one section. So
I'll tell you what the morale was like during this. We've actually caught some fish and done reasonably well, and we feel like we've had like 3 pegs that have been really poor in the section out of 5, and we're still up there. So obviously we're waiting for a draw at the minute. If that turns out anything like positive, I think we're going to the pegs like really boosted.
Yeah, absolutely. If we have got the right ends of sections today, we believe we could score really, really low. So it's just a case of seeing how it goes. It's, you know, we'll obviously speak about it after today, but you know, the way we're fishing the match, it's a bit strange because I don't think it necessarily lends itself to a win unless you got extremely lucky. But it does lend itself to very consistent scores, which is what I think's carried us through yesterday. It's prevented a blowout, and you know, even we had an appalling peg, which I don't think, you know, there's a chance we could have one or two today, but it's a lot less likely.
Chuck also into the mix. We've scraped the windscreen this morning. It's been freezing overnight.
Yeah, so yeah. 10 degrees the night before. 3 degrees this morning. Two degrees.
Will the bream feed?
Yeah.
Will it be a roach day? And obviously our tactics, which are predominantly roach tactics.
Roach dominated. Yeah. Yeah.
Will they be the right thing? That's, we're trying to be really positive about it.
Yeah.
I think we've got a cracking chance, but it's fishing. We've talked about this. It's fishing. Yeah. Not everything. It never ever runs smoothly.
No, it really doesn't. So anything can happen. Let's see what the draw brings. And I'm excited. I'm excited.
Hard day yesterday, Steve. But job well done for the team.
Yeah, it was really tough. I've not been that angry at a draw in a long time. I mean, D section. We all knew it was going to be Peggy. I didn't want basically 18 to 23. 23 was an end peg, and as it happened, that would have been okay, because there were some roach there, but I drew bang in the middle of it. And when I started, I'd have took 18, so 14th, I felt was a really good performance, but when you say 14th, it still doesn't seem good. But as a team, we're still in it. We are 11 points behind. And I look at it yesterday and just think, if I'd have got half a draw, half your points, we're banging it. You know, literally, we're only 2 points off. But even so, I still think a little bit of luck on the draw today, and there's no reason why we couldn't put in like a low 20 or even lower. But it is a venue where you do need a little bit of luck on the draw. So we've got the advantage today is in Lee's in D, and he has to be in the good half. The way the draw's done, you can only have one day in the good half. So Lee's going to be on a decent peg, whatever. And then if we can just get a bit of luck with the others, we're entitled to an end or an end but one as well. So that's going to help. And then if we all fish well, you never know.
A23.
What can you
put
out?
B6.
Got the same peg as well.
No,
two away.
Two away.
Hang on, that's good for roach there.
That's better than this.
Right. But
C19. Oh yeah, good. Okay. South Africans peg. Yeah.
Is that further up?
One? Yeah, it's around the corner. Yeah.
What?
Okay.
D5.
Oh, D5.
With some bream.
Yes.
Well done. So I'm not E1.
E1.
Oh yeah.
Oh, I didn't draw that. I didn't.
Once I plumbed it, we might have to make a call.
I'll be with you.
That Serbian caught there. You never know.
Nobody took it there yesterday.
I think I know once I plumbed it.
Yeah.
If it plums up alright, then
there's an outside chance. It could be like cakewalk.
Right. Yeah. Listen. Just listen. We're not fishing for grumbles. All right. We're not fishing for fucking fish that big. We fish proper. Fish to win. Yeah?
Got it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Right. You know what you gotta do. So let's get it done.
Everything's delayed half hour, right?
Everything's delayed half an hour.
Comes back half hour. Everything.
The whole program, bait checking, everything.
So half ten start today.
Half ten. So it's 8:30 in your box. So it gives us plenty of time.
Fucking another 30 minute shanking roach.
Exactly. We know what to do. We know what we've gotta do, so let's get out there and do it. Yeah? Right, sound. Good luck, lads. Everyone got your bait sorted.
Game on.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Oh, God. Sorry.
No, I
can't
see
on
set.
Fucking got it, all right.
Wake up. Yeah, the draw's been done. And it's quite complicated how they do the draw. So, got left with A section, same peg as yesterday, 23. We got left that in the bag, which, if you look at the results yesterday, you needed 1 to 12. B section, we've got B6, which, again, me and Mick did brilliantly off B4 yesterday. But most of the fish were caught from like 15 upwards. But I'm quite happy in C section. We've got C19, which is next peg to where Lee was yesterday, which I think is moving to the better pegs. So we're okay there. D5, which is again a good peg. So I'm happy with that. and then Stevens on E1. I don't think he'll ever let me draw for him ever again. So E1 wasn't the best yesterday, but today's another day, isn't it? So if anyone can pull it out of the bag, I'm sure Stephen can. So two good draws, one bad draw, and two medium draws. But with 23 peg sections, there's all to play for. You know, there's an odd fish here and an odd fish there that can make all the difference. So we've got to be positive. That's the only way we fish. We fish positive and we fish to win.
Will there be any things checked different today? Are you going to go out and out roach today, or is it going to be a bit...
Well, we haven't really drawn any, what we would say, bream pegs. We missed like 8 or 9 bream pegs in A section, as usual. Lee might have a chance of a bream, but we're gonna chuck in and see what's there, Joe. We can't exactly... we're not just going to sit there and fish for one or two big fish. We fish for points, and if there's any decisions to be made, I'll go down and make them and make the lads aware what they need to do to achieve the maximum points they can get.
A litre of worms in this tub, and I want some red worms as well. So I've got a little bag of red worms here that have been lovingly prepared for me by the team, and I want to try and get them in this tub. So I've got to keep them in a little bag to do that. What I might do, see if I can just sift a little bit of gump off them.
Gump.
Yeah, so they're gump free. There you go, look, nice red worms. Could be good today on this peg.
So this, obviously, this peg is a good area for sort of better fishing.
Every day, there's been a few bream in this area. Obviously, the weather is different to what it's been all week. It's you know, a very, very cold night, and it's very bright and sunny all day, not a cloud in the sky, so I'm happy because it's a deep area. I think even if there isn't some bream, there should be a few roach. There's the worms, look, in there. So we've got worms, tub of joker, and then casters and maggots in the last two, and some bloodworm, which you have to have in your little measure. This will be chucked away. These will be given to somebody over here, because I'm not allowed them. And then I've got my ground bait and a few other bits and bobs with me, so we're all ready to go. Bait check's going to be in about 5 minutes. Hopefully these baits are baits that are going to get us something like a few fish, but we shall see. Morning, you alright?
You will today.
Good, how are we doing? You alright? Obviously loads well under 6 litres. And then one of casters, you see in there, joker is in here. Look. Yep. Alright, worms in this one. And then casters, and this one is casters and maggots as well.
Okay.
You okay? And blood worm. Yappy? Thanks, guys. See you all later.
Well, we're just a few minutes before the all in on day two, and we're sat behind Steve Ringer, who's just preparing himself. He's drawn E1, which is a tricky proposition. It's in a bay of the lake, which is an unfancied area for sure. But the peg to the left, which is round the corner in the bay, caught 5 kilos of roach yesterday, which was unbelievable. Ended up really high in the section. And it's obviously given Steve a bit of promise and a bit of hope that there's going to be some roach maybe in this area. He's plumbed the depth extensively. He's spent over an hour plumbing the depth trying to find the right depths that the anglers want to fish in. There's certain depths for certain species of fish. The roach seem to like a certain depth. The perch and the other small fish like a certain depth. And the skimmers again, like really deep water. So Steve's obviously tried to cover his different depths by using different rods, different distances. And like I say, he spent a good long time plumbing up to make sure he's found that mark. And I believe it's at 54 metres he's found a depth that he's happy with, which is much further out than what they've been fishing all week. But it gives them that option of targeting those roach. Obviously, there's a key tactical decision to be made here, because Steve could quite easily have to fish for the small fish, the grumbles, perch and roach, little asp, sorry. But he could also catch some roach here long, maybe early and late. So there's a little tactical decision, because if he is going to go down the small fish route, he kind of has to do it quickly, has to get on it after about an hour to give him the time he needs to catch 250 of those little fish, which is what Michael Buckwalder caught yesterday. So a lot of, again, E section's a really tactical section. It was the same yesterday, because it's a low weight section, and 100 grams here or there can cost you 2 or 3 points, which is obviously we need the maximum. So this is going to be one to watch today, E1.
As with day one, tactical changes, small tweaks to the approach are going to play a massive part. The aim was to get England as high up the points tally as possible. And as you can see, Steve Ringham was in a real quandary of a situation. He still fancied catching a few roach long, but it was no doubt that he could definitely get good points if he just got his head down and fished for them small fish. So here we are, 20 minutes into the day, and already Steve has picked up his short rod. He's had no bites on that long line. He's on the short line. He's trying to catch his small fish. This was a consistent approach along E section yesterday. Just fishing short, 15 to 25 metres, and catching those small fish, perch, asp, odd tiny roach. Really important stuff. And if Steve could get 200 fish in the net, he would be well up the leaderboard and get his points for England. So, just left Steve Ringer, who was under captain's orders, changed to targeting those little perch and asp and grundles. And then we come around to Rob Button in C section. Rob's had a great start. He's got over 20 roach already in the first hour. And he's just having a great day's fishing so far. He's fishing sort of 30 metres out, window feeder. Looks like he's using casters on the hook. And he's doing well with the roach. On this C section, Rob's definitely at the good end. There's some good pegs in this section, peg 6, peg 9, really nice draws, but I feel like Rob we'll get good points here today, for sure. Just popping that window in. Quite short today, I'd say, 30 metres-ish. Much different to the other days when, like yesterday, he was fishing 40 plus metres, but he's out doing his thing. See, Rob is using a much shorter rod today. He's got like 11 foot rods rather than his usual 12 footers and 13 footers that they've been using all week. So shows that he's fishing closer range, but he's got 20 plus roach already. He's in great shape here in this section. Interestingly, the
lads put a lot of emphasis on hook choice and what hooks they're using and how they're hooking the bait. And this is a big factor. And I've already heard Frank Renner Graham West passing on a message as to what hook and how Robbie's hooking his hook bait, as he feels it's hitting him more bites, which is really interesting. You know, most people probably just assume that a hook's a hook. But it's not always the case. And Rob's obviously been keen to pass that message along to the other anglers, who, if they're catching roach, maybe try this hook line and how to hook the bait combination to make them more efficient. In the early going, Lee Kerry was definitely not having things all his own way. Just 7 fish in the first and 7 fish in the second hour meant that Lee was up against it, and he really needed some bonus fish to catapult him up the leaderboard. It just wasn't happening for Lee at the moment. The cold, bright conditions, the bream just were not having it. There was the odd peg that seemed to be throwing up the odd skimmer, but so far for Lee, it was a really, really tricky start. Just a few small fish to his name, and in desperate need of his fortunes to change. Lee decided to take the clip off his line and go 5 metres past his original fed swim to a distance of about 38 metres, and he caught a roach and a skimmer immediately, which showed promising signs. And just a few minutes later, there we go, he's hooked into his first bream. As we saw with Mick on day one, Lee immediately stands on his box. To get up above that shelf, there's a really steep shelf in this area, and Lee was definitely taking his time with this fish.
Go on, Lee.
A brilliant bream for Lee Kerry there. An absolutely massive fish on what was a tough day.
Right, we're back in B section. Now Mick Viles drew B section yesterday and had a great fourth. And he's back today, just 2 pegs away from where he was yesterday in B6. Now he's the most consistent man on the bank. He's had 8 roach first hour, 8 roach second hour, and 8 roach third hour. So, consistent result so far. Nothing spectacular on the fish count front, but he's had some good fish. Nice roach. So he's doing okay. Again, the pegs higher up that won the section yesterday are again performing today. But as we saw with Mick yesterday, a lot changed in the last 20 minutes for Mick. He caught a big roach and a bream yesterday in the last 15-20 minutes, so that could happen again today. In fact, the man next to him has got a good fish on now. Interestingly, the Spanish angler next to Rob is catching bream as well, which perhaps is their tactics, maybe fishing bigger baits. But interesting to see bream getting caught by 2 anglers of the same in the same team. Yep, nice big roach. Bonus fish today, that. It's noticeable, it's really bright.
Big roach. Lovely fish. Interesting, this is a peg that Mick practiced on Thursday. Caught three bream late, so although conditions are against us, definitely can't rule out that he might catch one. Even if it is literally in the last 10 minutes. Certainly wouldn't be a surprise. A23 was a peg that England had drawn on day one and unfortunately drew it on day two as well. Now A and B section were fishing incredibly hard on day two. There was just not a lot of fish to catch, there was no bream to catch, and even the roach were proving really hard to catch. Adam had had a reasonable first four hours, but it was slowing up. It really was slowing up. He was just catching an odd roach, an odd little grundle, an odd perch. Adam was still within touching distance though, and they felt that if they could catch a little bit more weight from somewhere, that it was in the chance of getting a really good score. So the decision was made with just 45 minutes to go to set up another rod, a little short rod, a little 9-footer that would allow Adam to fish for tiny fish close in. They felt if they could catch 300 grams of these tiny fish, it would be time well spent rather than gambling on catching maybe 4 or 5 roach on the long line. They just didn't seem to be feeding at that point. And this look on this short line just seemed to maybe be a safer option for the last half an hour, 40 minutes to get Adam that 300 to 400 grams that he might need. Now Adam decided to fish with just a short 9-foot rod, underarming the feeder out, and it immediately started catching fish. Nothing big, tiny asp, little perch, little grundles. But if he could catch that 300 gram target in that little short space of time, it could get England right up the leaderboard, and it might prove to be an important decision that the management made on day two. I'm going to give you the enviable task. What has Adam got, do we think? No idea.
No, I helped him with 1.4, 1.5 kilo. Adam doesn't know because he's in concentration.
Yeah, yeah.
There's a few around, there's a 1.6, 1.39, 1.28, 1.30, 1.540.
We could even be the right side of that or the wrong side.
Right side, but we knew what them little fish weighed if you caught 40 an hour and did it for 5 hours. When you kept reeling them in from distance, you can't. Some are 8 gram average, some are 15 gram average.
Here we go, get ready for this guess.
Important weights.
We need some luck here, we need to get above a few, don't we? And we've got in the prime position here.
Right, lockers in here.
Right, so this is Alan Wakelin, obviously weighing in for England. And the weights are incredibly close.
Oh,
1 kilo. If you can get like a big 1 kilo, that's
a big kilo.
That's good points.
Which is tight draw to a lot of weight.
That's a good. That's a.
It's like, nearly 2 kilo.
I could be good at that. Well done, Wakelin.
Well done, pal. Really good. Just 1.8 there.
Come on.
Lower. Yeah.
It's okay, it's okay.
There's a thing on the thing, you know.
191.
Ah, well done.
Go on, Waco.
Well done, mate.
That's good.
That's a good result, that.
That's a good result.
Well done.
Yeah, well done, pal.
That's beat a lot.
That's beat a lot.
Where's our, where's Richard gone?
Ricardo Cavallo. So,
brilliant, well done, Waco.
Thank you, Joe.
Marvellous. Very tall. Job done, well job done.
Done well there.
On the points front, job done.
Seconds. 73 points.
Who's won?
Serbia, 71 points.
I mean,
fucking hell,
here.
Look.
Wow, look at that.
We can see that, mate. Won't we?
Serbia.
First.
1 point. Look at that.
England.
1.5 points ahead of Hungary.
1.5?
That Aspin's done.
Done some good.
That's been a decision, hasn't it?
Wow.
Second.
Well done, boys.
Well done. Well done, that's awesome. Well done, Rich. Well done.
Are we happy?
Yeah, well, I thought it was going to be mega close for a bronze medal. So to get a silver medal out of it is fantastic.
Absolutely awesome.
I mean, Mick, we had down for 12th, he's finished 10th. So we've gained an extra couple of points there. A little bit unlucky not to get a couple more. And then Adam in this section has done amazing. Harry's managed 7th from here.
Yeah, that is awesome.
We've just pipped a few at the end, so
So it's all like come together right at the death, isn't it?
Yeah. You could say that.
That's been a tough step, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's just been a real hard work.
Tough one, isn't it?
I mean, I think I've finished Adam, 10 points. Adam and Mick here have drawn literally in the worst part of this bowl, so, you know, to scrape out of it with a silver medal is fantastic. I mean, we've even had a
shot.
You know, with a little bit of luck, we'd have had a touch of bronze today, which is incredible after the first day.
Yeah, unbelievable.
Yeah.
So is it official yet?
I'm not sure. It's official on the unofficial website.
On the unofficial score.
Well, let me just congratulate my teammate and Richard.
Turned out all right again, Dad.
Thank you.
Where's them two?
Hold on, mate.
Cheers, Jamie. It's a good result, that, isn't it?
Not many. There's Tom, look. Got the flag.
Tom's there.
We got the flag.
Flag bearer. I reckon, D.
Turned out alright, didn't it?
Turned out alright in the end.
Yeah.
Hit you.
Joe, words can't describe how I feel at the minute. When Thomas Welter comes up to you and says that you've done the best off the worst draws you could possibly have, from the most technical team in the world, Hungary. You know, you got something a little bit right. So it looks 2 points, which is not a lot over 2 days, but the mountain that we had to climb today was unbelievable. And the guys have just been, they've just been world class. That's all I can say. I mean, you got like Rob Button just winding a roach in a roach after two. That means we got the method. When we drew a good peg, we got the method really, really right. we took fish off other anglers, you know what I mean? So, and then the other end of the scale, you got Steve Ringer winding a perch in 8 grams. You know what I mean? He's caught over 200 little tiny perch, the best feeder angler in the world. That's what it means to be in a team. You know, that's how teams work now, and that's what I wanted to do, to change the mentality of the team. You know, we're all here for each other, and it's a lot of hard work by everybody. I just point them in the right direction. So.
Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant day. It's all moments like this, isn't it?
It's just, you know, when it was like an hour or so to go, you're trying to tot up points and everything like that. And I think we've actually finished second on the day. So we've, from when the steward brought me A23 round this morning, the same peg we had yesterday, I was like, well, this is it. But the guys just show what they've got, the metal they've got. They've got some balls on them, you know, and they're a bit good, aren't they? They're a bit good, Joe.
Here's England! Team England! Team England silver medal. And then the winners, give them a big round of applause. Team Serbia. With the cup, the World Cup Feeder Fishing 2022, Team Serbia!
So if you've enjoyed this video and want to see plenty more like this, don't forget to subscribe to the Preston Innovations YouTube channel. Completely free, and it's bound to put more fish in your net.